gentlemen, I'm here with... Now, you got mad at me.
It's Cordero Ulloa. Let me save you some time, Haywood.
Okay. Cordero Ulloa. You know, it's pretty damn hot in here. I have to wear this jacket. I don't know why you didn't take off the sweater.
Don't start it. Okay. I'm not in the mood for your crap today.
Okay. All right. We're all fine. Everyone's happy. You are taking on Dreamy Drew. Now, we haven't seen Dreamy Drew in PCW, so I have to ask, how do you prepare for a guy like Dreamy Drew?
What do you mean, how do I prepare? I'm the beatdown artist. I don't have to prepare for him. He needs to prepare for me.
Well, folks, there you have it. The Killa Gorilla, the beatdown artist, my little chunky monkey, Cordero Ulloa, gonna be taking on... The Killa Gorilla, Cordero Ulloa, taking on Dreamy Drew. Coming up next, Violent.
Rayshon Prince versus Jesse Garcia, 3. You guys ready for your next contest? The following contest is scheduled for right now. First, from your wife's wet dreams, he weighs in tonight at 250 pounds. God's gift to me.
Well, folks, Dr. Haywood here with another episode of PCW Prospects, starting off the action hot with the Sacramento Sex Pot, Dreamy Drew. I had a chance to speak with him backstage. Let's take a moment to go back and see what he had to say about tonight's match. Gentlemen, hide your wives. This man has been too sexy for PCW, but we finally let him in. I'm talking about Dreamy Drew. And Drew, the first thing I have to ask you is, where did you get those fantastic sunglasses? They are amazing.
Why didn't you ask your wife?
I don't believe Lady Haywood would ever step out on me. That's for another time. Drew, let's focus on your match. You're taking on Cordero Volvo, the Chunky Monkey, the Killa Gorilla, and he's promised to knock you out. How do you prepare for that, Drew?
First of all, you had it right. Chunky Monkey, because that fat boy needs to get back in the gym. And then knockout? Are you kidding? I am the knockout. And then... taking all the honeys away.
Folks, Cordero Ulloa versus Dreamy Drew coming up next. I'm going to have a talk with Lady Haywood. Hey, Lady Haywood, what the hell are you... Well, folks, I can assure you everything is fine between Dr. and Lady Haywood. Dreamy Drew just playing a little prank on me. Everything's okay. You could understand, though, why Lady Haywood would be so attracted to the Dreamy One. Cordero Ulloa, the Killa Gorilla. I think Zach Reed pronounced his name wrong. I'm always getting corrected on it. This guy, he's a savage. He used to be a ring announcer, but he's gone ape, to say the least. Well, Zach, you're joining me now. Your protege in the ring, the Killa Gorilla, Cordero Ulloa. Are you ready for this match?
Haywood, just a second. Got to strike the bell, waiting for Karina Kyle. Asking both. There we go. Here we go. Cordero, the Killa Gorilla Ulloa, and Dreamy Drew from your wife's wet dreams. I can't believe I had to make that announcement in front of collar and elbow tie up in front of the PCW fans at Prospects.
Well, the Dreamy Drew, he plays it racy. But the ladies like it. The ladies love him.
Dreamy Drew in amazing condition. I seen him show up here earlier tonight, collar and elbow tie up, backs the Killa Gorilla into the corner, and now we're going to see what Dreamy Drew can do in his debut against the beatdown artist.
Absolutely, Cordero, a beatdown artist going 2-0 in his career right now with a win over former champion Propane with a little help from you.
A little help from me. Dreamy Drew all over, shots to the midsection right now as Ulloa is being pummeled around the ring by the veteran wrestler. Hard buckle right now as Dreamy Drew is in control. Dr. Haywood, as we get set, June 11th, PCW Limelight, and a hard shot from Dreamy Drew. Oh, no.
Cordero starting to feel a little bit of that aggression, but he's going to need to bring out more of the savagery that we've seen in the past from him.
Ulloa didn't get everything on that big forearm smash, but if you poke the tiger, hard forearm from Dreamy Drew. If you keep another hard forearm, Dr. Haywood, if you keep poking this tiger through the cage, eventually that cage is going to open up and that tiger is going to come out, and that tiger just happens to be a gorilla in this instance. Irish whip hard back into the buckle, Haywood.
Well, Cordero has been poked a lot. Propane did it with an afro pick last time.
Oh, God, got to bring that up. What a night that was in Pacheco, California. Actually, Cordero Ulloa is undefeated right now in pro championship wrestling, and that's not going to work out for Dreamy Drew. As he goes for a second attempt, Ulloa counters. That's 280 pounds against his hard suplex, and that might be what he needs, Dr. Haywood, to build this momentum and get the audience behind PCW Prospect's fastest rising star.
Impressive strength, truly like a gorilla, getting Dreamy Drew up and hanging there for what seemed like forever and bringing him down with powerful impact.
Hard right hand to the sex pot. Ulloa starts to build another hard right hand from your mother's wet dreams, as Dreamy Drew says, and Ulloa starting to build a little bit of steam with the Irish whip. Reversal, kind of tight. Ulloa levels him.
Man, those big arms of Cordero. Oh, cover. 1-2.
Oh, Dreamy Drew escapes. Karina Kyle just hits a 2.5. Right now, the Killer Gorilla needs to sink his teeth and his big heavy paws in Dreamy Drew. And what a debut this could be, knocking off the Gorilla.
Absolutely. If Dreamy Drew could hand Cordero his first loss.
Wait a second. There's the hole.
Good night, Irene. That's what Cordero calls that forearm.
That's it.
It's 1-2-3. Dreamy Drew having his own wet dreams.
3-0 right now. Ladies and gentlemen, the Killa Gorilla, 3-0 in PCW, and he's becoming a main staple here at PCW Prospects. And there is the aftermath of what is an exposed 270-pound forearm to Dreamy Drew. Good night.
Zach gonna give us the final word. Dreamy Drew still out. Yep, folks, this one's all over. Dreamy Drew gonna head back and defeat Cordero Ulloa. Definitely a man to watch, a dangerous man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you guys have a good night. We're almost
I don't know how we're going to top that. I have no idea how we top that.
NorCal.com. Also, June 11th, Oroville Convention Center, PCW Limelight. We're on the way to July 16th at Pandemonium. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the Filthy Felt Open Challenge. Bell.
A true,
can
a
someone true please man. Put some pants on this man?
What is going on here, Doctor?
I don't know. We've got some technical difficulties in the back. Although with those bitch tits, he could be the American woman.
Hey, that right there is a man who is creating history every single day by being the whole effort pre-show, by being the only defeated man in professional wrestling.
0-90 is his record right now.
Hey, can you shut up so I can talk for a minute?
The mic's all yours!
Shut your mouth and let this man speak!
Oh, thanks for throwing me under the bus, Manny. I'll return the favor.
Better you than me, Doctor. No offense.
Man, you don't.
All of it taken.
Wow.
All right. The first thing I want to say, extreme measures, the champ, Sin, decided to call me out. So
is,
I got a
is Sin here?
Sin. Whenever you're ready, big man.
Is that a right challenge
here
to the PCW
I know you're
champion?
Here today, but whenever you're ready. So that brings me to my next point of business. This is the Filthy Mike Felch Open Challenge. So any man in the back that's got the balls to face me, come on out.
Who let Filthy Mike Felch off the pre-show, number one?
The challenge has been issued to any man in the back.
What? Who's going to answer?
That's no man.
That, you are correct, Doctor. That is not a man.
I may not be a biologist, but I can tell you when I see a woman. Is Lady Lindsay going to give Mike Felch his first victory?
Is this even a sanctioned match?
Does this look like a kitchen to you?
Oh! Mike Felch with some sexist comments. No wonder he's lonely.
PCW does not condone sexism, just so you know.
Mike Felch has 0 wins and 92 losses.
92 losses. I'm sorry.
That right there, folks, is impressive. The only defeated man. Well, apparently,
I missed two matches in between his match with Cordero then.
Folks, we have Bradley Rodden.
Bradley Rodden, why don't you scoot over here, Manny? So, or Bradley, you want to come sit in between us?
Exactly, Bradley. Right here, right here.
Well, I'm glad I don't have to sit next to Primetime for a change.
Bradley, you must be riding high after that win at Extreme Measures.
Of course I'm riding high. That's what Bradley Rodden does. But I'm here at Prospect to seek out some talent. We've got some talent there in the ring, although one of them has never won a match.
But, again, you want to make history, Bradley. There's only one competitor in the ring that's made history, and that's the defeated man, Mike Felch.
I gotta say, with Bradley Rodden in his corner, I think Mike Felch could actually get a win, could actually get some respect from the plebeians in the crowd.
Well, I'll tell you this, Haywood, I can definitely bring in the champion. Oh, look at this. look at the confidence.
You might have brought something special out of Mike Felch, Rodden.
Well, I wouldn't underestimate this woman he's in the ring with, though. You know, well, he's no slouch.
Well, hold on. She's an incredible slouch. She was against Jordan Blue at Limelight and in the pre-show. Jordan Blue tricked her with the oldest one in the book.
Wow.
Oh! What the Filthy Fist knocks her out! Did Filthy Felch just fist a woman?
You're right, Rodden? Yeah, come on. This is what you want?
Come on. Oh. Felch showing off for you, Brad.
First time ever.
We're about to see history, folks. This is impressive. Whoa, what?
Oh, DDT.
Felch is down.
Well, folks, it looks like Mike Felch remains the defeated man.
Well, I don't think Mike Felch is going to be a member of the Rodden family anytime soon. He just lost to a woman.
Well,
what are you out here for, Mr. Roddy?
I can't say much for your prospect in Mike Belch. He wouldn't know telling if it sat on his face. Lady Lindsay gives Mike Belch 0-93.
Well, Bradley, after last week, I'm sorry you came out here for such a bad prospect. Hopefully you find somebody else to get in that wrong family of yours.
Well, I wouldn't call it a dud, because Bradley Rudd, his family's never held the women's PCW title, so keep that in mind. Confirming. I'm just stating facts.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Mike Belch. Hey, 93.
Bradley Rotten, thank you for joining us.
First from Sacramento, California, weighing in at 250 pounds, Sanford.
Well, here he is, the necessary evil, on his inevitable collision with Alex Ace. I had a chance to speak with Sanders backstage.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with the necessary evil Sanders. And Sanders, it's necessary for you to meet your next competitor, the 7-footer Alex Ace, in the ring. Are you prepared to take on your biggest challenge yet?
Prepared. That is an understatement. He has made a habit of trying to prove that he is the biggest and baddest on this entire roster while forgetting the fact that I, Sanders, the necessary evil, is still around. He's new to California, i.e., he doesn't even go here. This is my territory. I've been here a lot longer than him. I've seen monsters like him, but this one, it's very interesting. He feels that it's necessary to try to make me feel small. Make me feel like he runs things here. I'm here to prove that it is necessary for me to put him down, to make him feel suffering in its purest form. I won't be stopped, and I can't be stopped from doing what is necessary to end him.
Alex Ace in some serious trouble when the necessary evil meets him in the ring. Folks, you are not going to miss this Battle of the Titans coming up right now.
Well, folks, there you have it. Sanders determined to prove that he is the big man in Northern California, is the big man in PCW.
There are not a lot of men who can make Sanders look small, but this is one of them. The anomaly, Alex A, standing at 7 foot tall, a true athlete, agile, powerful, strong. I had a chance to speak with him backstage. Let's see what Alex A had to say. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with please, sir, let me conduct the interview. I don't want to get shoved again. I'm here with the 7-footer, Alex Ace. Now, Alex, last time you were here, you complained that we had not given you any challenges. We were just feeding you rookies and boys. But now we're giving you a challenge in the necessary evil, the big man, Sanders. Are you prepared for him? Alex, trying to do an interview. Are you prepared to...
Do you know what today is?
April 23rd.
Right. And what happens on April 23rd?
St. George's Day.
Exactly. And do you know what happened to St. George?
Well, he killed a dragon and became famous for it.
Guess who the dragon is this time?
I'm gonna guess it's you.
Right.
And I'm gonna guess things are not going to go well for St. George this time.
That's right. Today, St. George, Sanders is gonna come face to face with Alex Ace. And this time, the dragon is going to win.
Well, folks, not a good feast of St. George if your name is Sanders. He may be getting burned. You are not going to want to miss this titanic confrontation coming up next. Alex Ace imagining himself as the dragon to Sanders' St. George on today, the feast of St. George. And Alex Ace ready to burn the landscape.
Tonight's main event here on PCW Prospects. 7 feet tall, Alex Ace. These two go all the way back to Last Man Standing with the face-off in the Rumble. It took an entire cast of guys to throw them over the top, Haywood. For the past 3 months, we've seen them go over on competitors. Ooh. So it's starting to get hot. It's going to get hot. These are two big bulls, probably the two biggest men on Prospects, and I'm pretty sure the winner of this contest might just get that call up to the PCW main roster.
Well, you know, there's a lot of big men going to be taking notice of this match. Bad news, Blakeslee, the other 7-footer at 500 pounds, and of course, the PCW champion, Sin.
A lot of big, fast, strong athletes. Like I've said before, I'm actually excited. Not excited, but I'm actually happy that I'm no longer the PCW champion. Nah, not really. But here we go, these two bulls, collar and elbow tie up, pushing around the ring, and Ace gets the better of Sanders, who is 6'6", by the way.
These guys do not like each other at all.
Sanders cuts Ace down. Nothing. Nothing right there. Oh, hard right hand. I've never seen someone take that uppercut from Sanders and not be affected. Irish whip, Sanders tackles. Ooh, Ace with an athletic flying knee and puts Sanders on his back.
A high knee to reach up and hit Sanders in the head like that.
From Barcelona, Spain, don't waste your time, young man. Get back on top of what calls him. He calls himself the necessary evil, and Sanders is now using the ropes for what they're supposed to be used for, to hold yourself up and pull yourself back up to a vertical base.
I have never seen Sanders in this kind of stagger before, knocked off his feet like this. Alex Ace, he is a dragon. He's a monster.
Ace, Irish whip, Sanders ducks underneath, shot to the lower back. Ace acknowledges. Now Sanders starts to dig away at the lower portion of the spine, and he's got the 7-footer down over the middle rope as the necessary evil starts to dig in, and now he's going to use every bit of that 5 count to wear Alex Ace down.
You've got to, when you are overmatched in size like this, in reach like this, a position Sanders is not used to.
Ace throwing those 7-foot, 270-pound forearms. Sanders back down to the lower part of the spine as he starts to work away, and he has the big man down to a knee. Sanders with a hard kick to the spine, and that's what he's going to have to do to maintain control, ground this big man. Two undefeated men also right here in the ring as Sanders and Ace battle to see who's going to move up in the heavyweight division at the main PCW roster.
I tell you what, the action has been picking up in PCW. I've been getting dream match after dream match. This is one of them. There's nothing I love more than two big meaty hosses beating the crap out of each other like Sanders is doing to Ace right now.
Sanders brings Ace out. Now he's going to work on a modified. What he has right here is a modified abdominal stretch with an outside overhook. And Ace right now, he's putting a lot of strain on that rib cage, and he's grinding that elbow into the ear and the neck and jawline of Alex Ace as Ace is digging for the audience. Like I said, one of these two men is going to go on, and they're going to move up in the division as Ace fights back, which bad news, Blakeslee and Sin, who is our heavyweight champion, and Sanders says no right now on this 7-foot suplex.
Well, in a lot more need to take notice of these two, not just the big men, the small men too, the Mike Shoots, the Christian Skies. They need to take notice because they are going to have to be going up against one of these two big men.
Bradley Rotten, I know, has come out here at Prospects many times before, scouting talent. Right now, he's got to be looking at one of these talents right here. Why wouldn't you want a 7-foot man on your roster? Why wouldn't Propane want a 7-foot or a 6'6" powerhouse bouncing and bodyguarding and watching his back? A lot of implications are coming from this match here tonight.
You are not wrong, or even more, perhaps a Manny Roa or a Sin taking on one of them as a bodyguard to maybe keep them away from their goal.
Big matchup right now. Single leg crab. Alex Ace down on the mat. Sanders in firm control. The winner of this contest is definitely moving up the ladder in the heavyweight division, but the heavyweight division is the PCW Championship. Ace is going to have to regroup right here, find his footing, if he wants a chance to move up to the main roster, because Sanders is looking pretty damn good.
Sanders definitely dissecting the bigger man, a hard chop to the chest. Just whittling away at that big oak, which is the strategy a lot of smaller guys have to use.
Exactly, including the last man standing rumble. We are looking at the fourth appearance here in PCW by both these men. This one has been building up.
Speaking of building up, Alex Ace building up some temper there.
7 feet tall, nasty, and a giant. And now Sanders might have just bit off a little more than he can chew. Ducko! Two big meat curtains, big meat hooks. I apologize, Dr. Haywood. That's what happened right there when a couple bulls run into each other. I apologize to the audience out there. I wasn't talking about meat curtains or beef curtains. I was talking about those big meat hooks on the hands of Alex Ace, and I slipped. Apologies around. The audience building up. I don't know what we got going on here, except I do know that the big, beefy hands of both these men, excuse my language.
Both of these men going back to square one, popping up hole, fireman's carry. Oh!
Samoan drop, that might be it. Lateral press, hook the leg ace. Little too close for comfort. Two men over 6 feet five, 1 7 foot. The anomaly, the necessary evil. We are in what I call, and he's stomping because he knows it's championship minutes and championship moments.
You are not wrong. Both of these men have done feeling each other out, and they're going to pull out all the
stars. Sidewalk slam. That might be it. Hook to the close leg. Ace got the shoulder up. Here we go, digging deep. Right now, these are the championship moments that we talk about in this industry. Sanders is, I don't know what Sanders is going to do next, but I know we're close to finding out the conclusion of this contest.
The necessary evil, going to do what's necessary. Perhaps going to the second rope, high risk here.
That's definitely out of his position. I wouldn't have gone there. But Sanders feels this is necessary to get the win. He says he's going to drop the big elbow.
One home.
You take a chance, you crash and burn, and the 7-footer is looking. There's a hard boot from Ace. That might be it right here. One, two, no. Hold on a second. That was about as close as you get right there.
Ref Gill's hand just a hair off the canvas.
These are two big men having a very great, and I'm going to use the word great, professional wrestling contest right here. Ace throwing up that hand signal, that hand gesture. Here comes that double choke slam. The mittens, no.
Sanders fighting his way out, fighting back.
Sanders showing me something here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Big 7-foot leg lariat. That could be it. Lateral press. All he's got to do is hook the leg, Haywood, and I think this thing would have been over, but Sanders is showing me something.
I can't help but be impressed by the toughness of Sanders, the athleticism of Alex Ace, the vertical leap that man gets to put that leg drop down.
He is very athletic for being 7 foot, but right now my attention has turned to the necessary evil, has turned to Sanders. We know he's big, we know he's strong, we know he's imposing, but we did not know that he could possibly compete at the main event level, and this audience is starting to get behind. Here comes a 7 foot choke slam, and no, Sanders counters.
Sanders fighting every step of the way, showing his toughness against the anomaly.
Anomaly, chest first into the buckle. Sanders is calling for his zone. Hand gesture and choke slam. Can he get 7 feet, 270 pounds off the... Yes! That might be it. That might be it, Dr. Haywood. Yes, Sanders.
Cover him.
Cover that man.
He's wasting time. What's he doing? What is he doing? Alex Ace got him in some kind of submission.
That's an alma plata. That is an alma plata. And Sanders, he's got the front of the heel on those size 18 foot.
I can't boom. Tell from this position, but it looks like he's got it locked in. Sanders fighting.
Sanders not tapping. Sanders not tapping. That arm starting to feel. Hold on, is he
That's
counting?
That's looking limp.
No, wait a second.
He's looking limp.
Defiant, he threw up a hand gesture through the legs. The Defiant, wait a second, here comes referee Gill. That's it.
That's it, he's gone.
That's it.
He's done. Sanders didn't tap. He passed out.
Hold on, I got an announcement to make.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Zach Reed, going to give us the official words. There it is, the anomaly. Alex Ace, the winner by submission. Sanders did not tap out. He passed out. Whoa, what a match, folks. The heavyweight division needs to be on notice. Everyone needs to be on notice because Alex Ace coming to the main roster, coming to limelight very soon. Folks, another great episode of Sanders woke up and he is not happy. Sanders not happy at all with the outcome. Cannot believe he lost. He never tapped. We have got a very angry necessary evil on our hands, folks. We will be back June 11th. Limelight at the Orville Convention Center. This is Dr. Haywood for Mr. Primetime Zach Reed telling you to take it easy, and if it's easy, take it twice.
And when you hear the sound of the drum, we'll be saying, here we come. Yeah, here we come. Hey, here we come. Here we come.